Hello everyone, FunshineX here. Welcome back to my Let's Play of Space Engineers. We're here on the moon, and the game just updated today, and I am so happy they fixed a lot of the crash and lag issues that I've been having. I've been playing for quite a while, as you can see, all the updates I've done here, and haven't had a crash once today, and that is super rare, if ever, I've had that. So, yeah, I'm pretty excited that they fixed a lot of the bugs, especially with mining. I haven't had any mining crashes as well either. Okay, so we've got the entryway. I've showed that before, but now I've gone ahead and filled in all the armor blocks pretty much in the upstairs here. I put some windows in. Not sure if I like how it looks up top there. I might just open it all up instead of having these kind of grid patterns, whatever. But yeah, we need to have some of these leading off into the sunset. This armor looks really weird with the lighting that I have. It almost looks like, I don't know, just weird. It's fuzzy. It's not flat like the other lights. Let me go and completely turn off my headlight from my suit so you can see what the base looks natural light. This I haven't really done anything with other than I put some lights over there in the drill. That made it look really cool. The rocks look good, but I haven't touched this room at all. Let's go ahead and go downstairs. I'll take the ladder. I've got a little bit of a problem. In order to make this wall here, I had to put this slanted block in. And by doing that, there's no way that I could put a light above the elevator shaft. I can't put one here or there, or in the elevator, or the ladder shaft, because the ladder occupies the entire space. So that means it's dark. There's no way to put a light in this whole thing. So, oh well, guess we don't need a light in there. But yeah, you can see I've lit up this area. Oops, forgot to finish that one. And lit up in here. Pretty cool. And I really like the way this turned out over here when you walk through the rocky area. This just looks really good, I think. And that takes you in here. I've added some lights. This is not, it's not perfect. There's some dark spots, but I think it'll work. It's better than relying on my helmet light. And then I haven't finished the back of the cargo containers. I think I'm just going to wall that off, but I haven't decided 100% yet. And then in here, yeah, this was hard because there's not a lot of ceiling to attach lights to. You can't put lights on rocks, right? So I put as many lights as I could. Some of them are in the white hue. Some of them are in the blue. I need to fix that, don't I? Okay, I'll get that fixed. And it's weird. This doesn't look like a window at all, but it is. I wish their window would have a little bit more something to it. Maybe I'll change it out from a 2x3 to like a 1x, you know, 6 1x1s instead, so it actually looks like a window. But yeah, that's that room all lit up. I still need to weld the floor, but everything's lit. And then we'll go back up here. So let me know if you like the lighting in the base, what you think about it. I still have some of you guys to weld up, don't I? Might as well get that done while I'm here. Yeah, it doesn't look that dark. And obviously you're just kind of climbing, coming in here and climbing anyway. I finished off the second capacitor. I'm not sure they're going to really do anything useful. That right now they're just set to store power. And they're never ever going to give off any power. I guess if I run out of uranium, they'll be a good backup. But I think I'm going to add two more, one right on top of the reactors and one right above it. So it looks really cool, or it will look really cool. Today we are going to focus on, the cargo bay, or the ship bay, I guess it would be called. And that will be out here. I'm going to need lights on because I don't have any lights out here. So what I think I want is a platform that you walk out onto down the middle, so you can kind of get to any ship you want, and then I'll have my ships on kind of the sides, and each of them will have their own hangar door that they can fly out of, so that when I'm bringing in one of the ships, I just kind of fly in here and then park it right here. So I'm going to go ahead and move these in and see how they fit. Why? There we go. So I'm going to have to fly this guy in third person. He is pretty big. You can see I started running a pipeline. Those little red squares, you might be able to see them. Probably not in YouTube, but I'm going to have that there. So he's going to probably want to land right there. Okay. So how far is he going to stick out before we can put an actual door in? Probably, to be safe, I could put a door right here. I think so. And then how wide is he is the other question. He fits all inside of three blocks, but I think I'm going to want an opening of five just to make it easy for him to get in and out. I don't crash into any of the walls. So, something. Let's see, how big does he need to be? And then can we go straight across from there? I'm going to change this all out from being square blocks later. It'll have more angles like the rest of my base, but right now I just want to see the sizing. Yeah, and then I think I'll have something here just like as a landing strip. It'll extend out. Yeah, and then the door will be right there so you can fly in and out. Okay, so that's good for them. Let's go get some of these other guys here. These guys are much smaller. So they changed something to do with batteries, and it destroyed this ship. Like, it always thinks it's out of fuel, even though the battery you can see is completely, well, you know, it's 3/4 full. It would last quite a while, but she always complains and comes on as like, oh, your battery's low. So this one will be pointing out this way. And we can put the connector right on this block, maybe. Yep, that'll work. Okay. So this guy, he probably only needs a nice small little door here. Let's see, those drills go out a little bit further, so we'll do it right here. So this room will be a little bit asymmetrical, which will probably bug me, but I'll get over it. All right, that will be your window, and you can have a little flight deck as well coming out. Okay. And then, oops, did I miss a block here? Put them right here too. Perfect. Let's get the welding ship into place. Where do you... Oh, yeah. I haven't flown this ship in a while. Oops. Turn off. Landing gear? There we go. He's got landing gear on. Oh, I forget how bad this guy is. He's got so little engine power. Alright, and he doesn't have a connector at all, does he? So he can just kind of land wherever. But we might want to line him up. Just so they're at about the same place. Yeah, something like that. Okay, and then, yeah, the same kind of window should fit him as well, so. Oh, come on. It'll be a little tricky to fly them in this small of a doorway. But let's see how bad it's gonna be with this small. easy to fly out because you're there. But let's say I'm coming in from doing whatever. Come to the landing deck, back it in. That's going to be hard to back it in. Might have to fly in forwards and then leave myself enough room to turn. But I'll probably paint the ground a little bit different so I know right where to land, and we should be good. Sweet. Okay, well, those are my three ships there. Let's go ahead and mark the area that they're going to have connectors. So that will be right here for you. Can I fit down in here? Oh, let me in. Seriously? Let me in. There we go. And that's where I want to connect to you. And we need all this stuff for that. Motors, tubes, construction components, plates. Motors, tubes, plates, construction components. Okay. Let me in. Will this connect to both of them? Should. Okay, turn yellow. Good. And then six and a six. And a connector. Will that fit with him on the ground? Kind of built this in a really weird way. That's a bummer. I think I need to lower down this connector, maybe. I mean, I guess I could just have him kind of more floating in the air. Whoa, too much. That was a lot of power. Holy crap. Oh, would have hit the roof if this thing had a roof. Let's do that. Missing 20 computers. There's 100. Oh, but now, that's going to be tricky because I've got to fly him straight out. But he'll be like sitting on this. I'm going to have to make that door bigger. Or have him go through the ceiling. Seeing how he kind of already wants to because he's got so much power. All right. So what do I think? So he's definitely going to have to fly up to clear the connector. We could just make this really tall. Let's give it a test. Testing is good. All right, so I'm in my ship, ready to leave. So I turn my thrusters on, I undock, and I hit the ceiling. So I fly out, we go on a mission, and then we're coming back. Probably pretty heavy. This is a transport ship, right? Be moving real slow at this point. come into here, kind of line it up with this guy, and then flip 360. Something like that. That's not bad. I can do that. If I could line these stupid things up. Come on. You can do it. There you go. You did it. All right, we'll go with that. Maybe I'll make a ceiling hanger as well, but that's good for that. All right, now I need to find a mod that will make a big door like this. As far as hangar doors, I have vanilla. We have blast doors. Yeah, okay. Well, let me go searching on the workshop to find some kind of a big doorway that we can put in here that will open and retract. And I'll be right back. Okay, guys, we're back. I've been out to the workshop. Got three mods to check out, see which one we like the best. The first one just improves the vanilla blast door. Makes it a lot bigger. So we could put one of these. Oops. Down like that, and that one would extend up all the way to the top instead of a normal blast door, which only goes, or hangar door, which only goes three blocks, I believe. And this one that I got, it's called the S- hangar door mod. I think it goes up, I don't think it's huge, the number of doors. The top one is 32, so you could have a huge hangar door. But yeah, so we could extend these all the way across the exit of the entrance. The other one I got was this force field door. So this is a laser or force field that we would put down probably in the ground here, and then it would project a blue laser force field up to actually be the door. And then the last one that I got is this glass bridge, which I think can be used as doorways. Yeah, it said glass bridge and doors. I don't know, maybe this is not the intended use of this, but... So I think you put it like that, and then it extends up that way. I think. So let's try and just build these, see what they look like. This one needs plates, you need small steel tubes. Are you going out that way? Is that how you're shaping up here? I don't know. Plates, small steel tubes, and glass and girders. Okay. Get them out of here. That must be inside the other ship. Alright, so some plates. Too many. Why can't I pull these back? Weird. Oh, because it was trying to stick them in there. Some plates, some girders, some glass, and computers, maybe? All right, so I think we're ready to build these up. Wow, that one needs a lot of steel plates. Let's grab some more then. Okay. So how do we control these guys? I need to actually open them now. So we'll grab the control panel and look for the hangar door and hit open. Oh, closed is like extended. Okay, that makes sense. So that'll go out. Then we'll get the force field door and close that. And then we'll get the glass bridge and close that as well. Okay. So, yeah, this one would definitely need to be down in the ground because it has five blocks of force field. And then you got the hangar door. And did this one do anything? It doesn't appear to have done anything. Unless it went the other way, like it went down maybe? Yeah, let's try it again. Yep, there it went. We had sent it down. So the glass is just appears to be an image, not an actual block, but we'll see. Oh, I like the opening. That's cool. Can I fly through it? No. Okay, so it is a block. Interesting. Well, we got some good choices. I think just because the theme, that blue of that force field, fits really well into the color scheme of my glass, I think it's going to look the best. And I think it, yeah, I like it. So let's, we might use these other ones somewhere else. Oh, I'm oh, that was not a good idea. Whoops. Supposedly they added blinking now. When you highlight over something, it doesn't stay yellow, it blinks. Let's see that in action. Ooh, pretty. I think a lot of people are like, well, once I highlight over it, I can't see what it is. I can't tell. All right, is there any other pieces? Hope not. So we are going to need to put this down in the ground. So let me do that so this doesn't detach. I could put it in the ceiling, I guess. Do I want it to open up or open down? I think I want it to open down. Another question is, can I put these, right here? Where did it go? What the heck? Like, where's the block? I put something here, like, because I can't put a... It's like, it's down in the ground now. Wow. No? All right, something has gone horribly wrong. Yeah, it like wants to put it down in the ground. It thinks there's already one down there. Are you down here? There you are. I don't know how you got there, but you are way too low. We can now at least put a block here. All right, that's what I wanted to see. Apparently, if you don't have a block under them, it just goes into the ground like a million blocks. So I'll have to just drill out a little bit. Much better. Okay. Okay, I think that looks good. If it would place in the right spot. There we go. So let's get this welded up now. Kind of expensive. That's not a joke there, but it looks beautiful. Do all the plates first. Let me take a quick break since we're getting long, just to weld this up, and then we can see it with the actual door closed. Okay, they are all welded up. They don't look any different, but that's just because there's no build states on them. We'll go ahead and get all of our force field doors now. Take them all and close them. I think it's an instant thing. So the next thing I need to worry about is some kind of sensor to open or close it. But that's not going to work because it would then, when it's parked here, it would open up. It could be like, oh, you're ready to leave. So I think, like, if we're in here, can we hit... Okay, we're gonna need an antenna to actually control it. So let's get one of those then. We don't have an antenna on the base. Oh, we've got the laser, the regular. Laser takes quite a lot of weird stuff, so let's just get the regular. Now we can stick this. Maybe just right in the middle here. It's even. I don't have a lot of space for an even block. I think I'm just going to put it up here. All right, you need steel plate. Construction, small, large, computer, and radio. Do we have any radio? No, we do not. How many do we need? 40. Now I've got to find them somehow. They're there. 10, 20, 30, 40. That was easy. We're completely full though, so let's get these motors out of here. Oh, come on, stop rotating. Okay, we're short just the radio and the large steel tubes, and she'll be up and running, and we can actually open our door and close it. Gonna put all this crap back in here. These things are so heavy. Okay, I think we can get the rest in one more scoop here. Yay, all right. Radio, antenna, you are good to go. All right, what color shall we paint her? Let's paint her yellow. I don't know. Now, should be able to get in the ship. Okay, switch this. Nope, it's not broadcasting. It is broadcasting. Is that because I'm attached? Okay, so it's attached, then let's turn you on. Now. Can I switch? Oh, this is the Harmony. I thought this was the Champ. Oh, well. I called it the Champ last time. Oh, because this ship doesn't have an antenna. Ah, that would help. That would help indeed. Are you locking on? Oh, did I just turned the entire freaking station off by hitting... Why, while I was attached? Oh, that was bad news. Okay. Let's go fix that. All right. Station turn on. Why? There we go. That's better. Okay, so we're going to need to make another antenna here. Where is a good place for one? Maybe right here in the collar? How about right here? Will you fit right here? So much stuff to do. Okay, built. Sweet. Now, can... I want to be disconnected, which... I am. Then, K... Check the base. There we go. Now we can get all the force fields. Put them all in one, and we'll call this Harmony Bay Door. Save it. Can hide all these. And now we can just say open. Sweet. Fly on out. And then return. That was a long trip. Come in for a landing. Connect. Are we connected? Stop with the crazy view. Yep. All right, we're connected. And then Harmony Bay door closed. Awesome. I love it. Oops, better turn the engines off. Sweet. And I'll figure out how to integrate that big square block into the look and feel of the rest of the base. And it looks like we're going to need to move. I was anticipating having another ship like this maybe here. But if we do, we're going to need to move it away because this one took from the center 1, 2, 3. Actually, no, that might work. So I'll do a door right there. Yeah, that'll work. Okay, and then we can also do a smaller force field door for the little guys over there. And we'll have our hangar bay, ship bay. All right, I think that's going to do it for this episode, guys. If you liked it, hit that like button. Help me out. And subscribe to my channel if you are here and want to see more. I'll see you guys in the next episode of Let's Play Space Engineers. Catch you guys later. Bye.